Hi, students. Today's topic is descriptive language. This is for ninth graders studying English as a first language. We are your teachers, Oyuna and Brandy, and we are from the Mongol Aspiration School. We have prepared this lesson for you, so enjoy it, and feel free to take some notes as we go along. Today, we are going to improve your writing skills. We will be learning about descriptive devices, and we hope that at the end of the lesson, you will be able to better describe things. Let's look at two descriptions. I'd like you to tell me which is more descriptive. A. On the hill, there was a pink house among the trees. Or B, halfway up the slope, guarded by a group of tall, slim cypress trees, nestled a small strawberry pink villa, like some exotic fruit lying in the greenery. Of course, B is more descriptive. If you were asked to draw this house, B would be more helpful because it has more description. So you may ask, how do I make my sentences more descriptive? Figurative language devices will help you. Figurative use of language or imagery is the name for colorful, vivid writing that brings to life inside your head and makes you see them clearly. Without imagery, reading and writing would be deadly boring, and it'd be much harder to know what a writer wanted you to see or feel when you read a book. For example, if you wanted to describe a woman's hat as big, you could say instead, her hat was like a bird's nest perched on top of her head. Do you like her hat? Nice, isn't it? So let's look at some figurative language devices. Metaphor. Personification. Simile. Alliteration. Onomatopoeia. Hyperbole or over-exaggeration. Idioms, and many others. We will wait as you write these down. The first one is metaphor. Metaphor means a form of comparison that directly compares two unlike things. This is my baby sister. This is her doll. These two things are different. One is a person and one is a thing. But I can compare my sister's size and sweetness to that of the perfection of her doll by saying, my baby sister's a doll. Let's look at others. The field is a rainbow of colors. The leaves are a blanket covering the ground. The lake is a mirror of beauty. The clouds are balls of cotton. A Another figurative language device is personification. Personification talks about a thing like it's a person, giving something non-human human qualities. This is where you write about something like the weather as if it's a person with thoughts and feelings. It's a kind of metaphor. For example, the sun's trying to come out. The sun is smiling. Don't forget to write these examples down. The next device we'll talk about is simile. Simile is a direct comparison introduced by like or as. For example, the smoke hung from the chimney like a drooping flag. More examples. The trees are like a canopy protecting the road. The church is like a magical castle in the sky. The lake is as smooth as glass. The sun shone like a beacon in the night. Don't forget to write these down. The island is like a star from the sky. The tree is like an oasis in the desert. Another device is alliteration. Alliteration is the repetition of a single letter. For example, Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled peppers. It also can be a combination of letters. For example, she sells seashells by the seashore. Alliteration can also be used to create a more serious effect, like in this poem. Snake. He sipped with his straight mouth, softly drank through his straight gums into his black body silently. Did you notice all the S sounds, as in snake? Onomatopoeia is another fun device. It's when a word is spelled the way it sounds. For example, six burgers were sizzling on the grill. Or a snake slithered through the grass. Other words you could use would be bang, crash, pop, or splash. And let's not forget hyperbole or exaggerations. An exaggeration is when you say something is much bigger or better than it really was. For example, I am so hungry that I could eat a horse. In fact, no one could eat an entire horse. Another example, it was so dark that I couldn't see my hand in front of my face. See if you can make sentences with these words: hot, tired, or excited. the last one for today is idioms. Idioms are groups of words whose meaning is different from the ordinary meaning of the words. The context can help you understand what an idiom means. For example, it's raining cats and dogs. This means it's raining very hard. Please look at these pictures. The Beverly sisters insisted on walking to church, even though it was raining cats and dogs. See the cats and dogs falling from the sky? Have you ever seen this? Funny, isn't it? Or how about just thinking about 6 more weeks of winter had poor old Ben and his cat and dog and mouse feeling blue. They were feeling very sad. See the raccoon in the tree? But the dog is barking up the wrong tree. We would say, he is barking up the wrong tree. This means someone is looking for something in the wrong place. Okay, those are the devices we are going to talk about. Use them wisely and widely. Now let's practice. Tell me which device is being used in the following sentences. Write your answers in your notebook as we go along. First, the sea licked the grass at the edge of the shore. Is this a simile? Personification, metaphor, or an idiom? Did you guess correctly? Wonderful. 2. You're just throwing money down the drain. Is this a metaphor? An idiom, personification, or simile? Did you guess idiom? Good job. 3. These walls have ears. Is this a simile, personification, metaphor, or an idiom? Did you choose personification? Great! 4. His room was a junk pile. Is this a simile, a metaphor, personification, or an idiom? Did you choose personification? Excellent. 5. The train was an angry animal roaring down the tracks. Is this a metaphor, a simile, an idiom, or personification? Did you choose metaphor? Wonderful. 6. The hungry waves grabbed our sandcastle and pulled it into the foamy sea. Is this an idiom, a metaphor, a simile, or personification? Did you choose personification? Good job! 7. The baby's skin was like a rose petal. Is this personification, idiom, metaphor, or simile? Did you choose simile? Good job. 8. His pen flew across the page, frantically trying to catch up to what the teacher was saying. Is this personification, metaphor, idiom, or simile? Did you choose personification? Good, I think you're getting the hang of it. How about 9? The moonless night was dark as black velvet. Is this a simile, a metaphor, an idiom, or personification? Did you choose simile? Awesome. 10. The sheets hanging on the clothesline danced in the wind. Is this a simile, personification, idiom, or metaphor? Did you choose B, personification? Great! 11. You are as slow as molasses in January. Is this an idiom, a simile, a metaphor, or personification? Did you choose simile? Wonderful. 12. The bacon was sizzling in the frying pan. Is this personification, hyperbole, onomatopoeia, or metaphor? Did you choose C, onomatopoeia? Very good. 13. Some students would rather eat dirt and die than have to sit down and read a book. Is this A, onomatopoeia, B, hyperbole, C, idiom, or D, personification? Did you choose B, hyperbole? Good job. Last one. Jovial Jake joined Judy for juice. Is this onomatopoeia, hyperbole, personification, or alliteration? Did you choose alliteration? Excellent. Here is a list of all the answers so you can check. Please think about what we have learned today. We have learned many figurative language devices. To recall them, please watch this video.
Learning About presents Figurative Language. Have you ever heard someone say that time was money? Or told someone to call you back because you were all tied up? Do your parents complain that money doesn't grow on trees? If these expressions sound familiar, then you already have some experience with figurative language. In this movie, we will explore some of the common forms of figurative language, including metaphors, similes, personification, hyperbole, and more. A metaphor describes one thing as being another, but the reader understands that this is not so. The metaphor makes a comparison that helps us see an object or a person in a new way.
Today I'm going to tell you about similes. Similes are phrases in English that tell us how one thing is compared to another. So for example, right now I am grinning like a Cheshire cat because it's comparing my smile to the smile of the Cheshire cat. I could say that you are as strong as an ox because I'm comparing your strength to the strength of an ox. It tells me how strong you are. I might say that you're as quiet as a mouse. Or floating like a butterfly, because it describes and compares your movement to the movement of a butterfly. Here are some more similes that compare one thing to another. Have a look at these and then see if you can think of, or if you've heard of, any others. Bye for now. As light as a feather. As slippery as an eel. Standing like soldiers. As cunning as a fox. As hard as nails. As tough as old boots.
Personification is giving human traits to an animal, object, or idea. Let's see how we can make this sentence better by using personification. The boys stared at the flames. We can pitch a better sentence by using personification. Let's try it. The boys stared at the dancing flames. In this sentence, we gave the non-human flames the human action of dancing.
Here, we're going to look at alliteration. Alliteration is when lots of the words in a sentence start with the same sound. You would find alliteration in poetry or stories. It is used to add life to the story or to draw your attention to certain words. Let's look at some examples. Frank fought Fred ferociously. Tracy's trolley trundled towards trouble. Gary got Grant's gold guaranteed. Be aware that the words don't need to be next to each other in a sentence. There can just be many words in a sentence that start with the same sound. Terry tipped up the table during the terrible tussle. And remember, it's the sound at the start of the word, not the letter. For example, Phil phoned from France to Phil Franken on the football. So, alliteration is when lots of words in the sentence start with the same sound. Remember to regularly recall this relevant report.
Onomatopoeia! A fun word to say, but what does it really mean?
Roar!
A word that
imitates
the sound it represents. Whenever a sound is needed to describe an action or thing, watch out for
pong,
boom,
flush, pop, bang, splash, crack, click.
Hyperbole. Hyperbole is exaggeration for effect. It's usually done to show strong feeling or emotional response.
We'll be right back.
And today, these eyes and I will be getting together to teach you some English idioms. You think, because I'm not facing you, that I can't see what you're doing. But you're wrong. I've got eyes in the back of my head. In English, if someone knows everything that's happening around them, even though they can't see it, we say they have eyes in the back of their head.
Did you enjoy the video? The last thing for today is to see if you can describe one of these pictures using figurative language. Now, why don't you read your descriptions to your partner? Thank you. Did you like the partner's work? Your homework for today is to read and choose a page from the book and write down the paragraphs and sentences which describes a person, place, the weather, atmosphere, into your notebook. and thank you for watching. Good luck.